Pavelski. Sidestepping that check was Schmidt. He gets leaned on a little bit more by the San Jose captain. Braun waits for the puck. And another penalty call as Pavelski was still jousting after that confrontation. In comes Evander Kane. And here we go. Tempers flaring.
Belmar looks hard. I believe the original call is going to go to Shea Theodore for the slash in the pile. And then Joe Pavelski got involved with somebody in front. Belmar took a pretty good whack in the exchange. Frustration starting to come out. And you know what, Dave? You asked what Peter DeBoer would like to see. I think he might want to see a little bit of this. Guys that aren't happy with the way this game has gone. Good battle down low as Pavelski, the leader on this team, continues to get involved right there. The cross check by Theodore, the whack right there by Pavelski. So I was wrong. It was going to Pavelski on the first one. Theodore is the one that kind of initiated the contact. And then Kane comes through high on Belmore, knocks him down. And this is the first scrum we've seen in this game. As Belmore looks like he took a pretty good one. And that's going to be a 5-minute major to Kane for cross-checking and a game misconduct. And Pavelski will also be in the box 2 minutes for that initial whack. I thought it was Theodore on Pavelski, but the cross-check didn't get called. The slash did.
Foyle, save made by Anderson. And Burrows can't get it out as it's taken back by the Devils again. Here's Stafford, the dish for Boyle, and a drive that's blocked away. Saring try, covered here by the Senators as players go crashing into the net, which is off the mooring, and look out.
Well, Alexander Burrows went out for Taylor Hall. Taylor Hall crushed him with the hit. Devils should get something out of this. Look at the knee to the head as well. And if the Devils don't get a power play or two out of this one, I'd be surprised.
We'll step aside in Ottawa past the midway mark of period two. It's a 4-1 Senators lead.
It started right here with the big hit from Taylor Hall and Burrows. Arms down, looks like it's clean. He doesn't like it. Burrows takes exception, gives Hall a whack, a cross check. Devils get a good opportunity around the goaltender Anderson. Then all, everything, shall I say, breaks loose. Smith gets the ball, Boyle steps in, and then the attack from Burrows. He ends up with a double minor. Watch this knee right here to the head. That is unnecessary stuff you don't want to see, Kanji. Burrows, one more look at it as Taylor Hall covers up, and look at the knee. I mean, it's pretty blatant.
Here it is. Here's Scott Antipin with the puck. Just gets rid of it, and it doesn't look that bad. I don't know. It's maybe, we'll see here a closer view. His head, oh, his neck goes, and then it hits the glass there. Just contact from the back side there. It's a tough, it's just, you hate to see anybody get hurt. And he went down and he didn't move much after that hit. He was pretty still until the medical staff got out there.
Pesek, the backhand tap into space. Holden takes it away. Trocheck runs into Backes, who says, "Are you okay, bud?" Now Matheson is gonna go. His first fight of the season against David Backes. Backes the headless horseman, and the linesman step in just as Backes was ready to go.
Well, that's an instigator.
No question.
The question is, how many penalty minutes was David Backes going to get on the hit on Trocheck? There was some question whether Trocheck was even going to play tonight. Obviously, he's one of the key cogs to what Florida's doing. There's the hit by Backes.
Is that not a legal hit?
Yeah, it's Trocheck that's, in a vulnerable position.
But it's a deflected
puck. Pulling the puck in his skates. He's trying to make a move to the inside. Yeah, you're fair game. You can still be hit. But again, the league is saying the onus is on the hitter, which is what we don't like. But that's the way it is. Backes wants to finish his hit. He gets him up high because of where his head is.
Oh, my gosh.
Relative to the ice.
So Charlie McAvoy, when Hornquist just about beheaded him at TD Garden, does not get that grace. But here it's going to be a penalty against Backes. That'll be interesting to sort out.
Yeah, consistency, Jack. You know it's an issue.
Trocheck is moving rapidly toward Backes.
Yeah, he just played the puck.
Yeah, and he hits him in the triceps area. I mean, upper arm.
But any hits to the head is what they're taking a look at. Referees are putting their arms up.
No penalty time posted yet.
Well, the arm went up for the hit. The referee put his arm up on that hit by Backes.
A match checking from behind on David Backes.
However, he was defended, and it's Domestikov to Kucherov. Domestikov loads up, fires, save.
Oh!
Bernier, he goes crashing into the boards. The Lightning object to that hit from Johnson. A penalty was upcoming against the Avs, and all sorts of fists are flying and behind the net.
That's nasty. That's when a guy is really vulnerable. And Johnson just shoves Domestikov as he's reaching, and he went screaming into the boards. And that's why all the Lightning reacted. It was Domestikov and Kucherov coming through the neutral zone with a give and go. And Victor Hedman is giving the what fors to Eric Johnson, and he should.
Well, as Domestikov being attended to here by head athletic trainer Tommy Mulligan, we'll be back in just a moment.
Watch the left side of his screen. And there's the slash. He's getting the original penalty. That's a cross check, and that's boarding. There should be at least 9 minutes in penalties as far as I'm concerned, because you can see the referee's arm. He definitely got him for slashing. That is definitely a cross-check, and he's in a vulnerable position. You can see what happened to Domestikov as he went into the end boards. That should be 5 minutes for boarding for me. We'll see what the final penalties are. I see 5 minutes up on the board for Johnson right at the moment, but it certainly shouldn't stop at just five.
A sharp left.
Wachowski still yapping as he shows the gates. As we went to break, everything broke loose between the benches. You saw Wachowski was still yapping at the Flames bench, and we have just seen a brawl, including Mantha on top of Travis Hamonic in between the benches.
Hamonic is just getting up off the ground. Unfortunately, the gate was opened to get Wachowski off the ice. And this is what the Flames did not like. They thought Wachowski took a liberty on Kulak after he had already stunned him and knocked him down on the ice. Hamonic was vocal with this. Wachowski went to the penalty box. He came off, the door right in front of me opened, and he came off and then went back onto the ice and had an altercation with the Flames bench. Hamonic came across, he ended up in it with Mantha, and then Mantha fell through the door with Hamonic, that the door was already open. Hamonic certainly not happy that the door was open. And this was a lot that went on between these two benches, and Mantha and Hamonic went at it pretty strongly in between these benches. And unfortunately, watch Hamonic and Mantha. The gate has been open for a good 15, 20 seconds, and as they move themselves along here, unfortunately for Hamonic, he's gonna have no back support that he thinks is behind him, and he goes right through the door. And that's where he goes down right there, and that's unfortunate that there was too many bodies to get the door shut. And really, there was nothing to hold them up, and a lot of upset players.
Even things out a little bit. Continue to scramble. Now Gudas in there too, so it's 3-on-3. Now Gudas has his helmet. Oh, Gudas with a chop at the helmet of Perreault, and that was spotted.
And took his glove off to make sure he got that stick back into his hand right there, and went on to play the remainder of that shift.
Perreault is getting a penalty as well.
And then both players with contact. Perreault took the helmet off of Radko Gudas. Radko came down hard with his to the side of Perreault's head. And you're going to take one more look at it. There's Watch Pro 85 in blue as he spins off of Ratko and then ends up taking the helmet off of Ratko. It goes right there, and then Ratko comes down with the stick on the side of the head.
And we'll wait and see. It looks like they pointed to the Philadelphia bench like they may be taking him out of the game. They are. Gudas is being sent to the locker room.
Sent wide by Chara. Stops up, got sandwiched by Chara and Tommy Wingles, and then in came Nazem Kadri, and the play is stopped, and I think it's Kadri that's going to get the penalty.
I'd be worried that Kadri's going to be gone on this one as he came late, as Wingles avoided the first hit and Kadri came flying in.
In support of Mitch Marner, who'd been hit by both Chara and Wingles. And you see Wingles gets some attention from the trainer. And Kadri gets attention from the linesman as he's ushered towards the penalty box for the second time in this period.
They don't like the first call against Kadri, but I think this one, there's no question that it was deserved.
Chara on Marner, in comes Wingles. Kadri didn't like that, and so he comes after Wingles. Here's the latest play.
Well, here's what the reaction was. An elbow by Wingles up to the face of Marner. No call on that, and Kadri was just coming in. Look at the reaction of Rask and Chara. And as I mentioned, this one ends up being a 5-minute call. That, I thought, should have been a call on Wingles, but there's no question about this one as Kadri comes late, jumps up, and Wingles is up and back on the bench, but Kadri is gone.
Out of the game at 4-1 in the third period. You know that the Department of Player Safety will be looking closely at that one too, won't
they? And Wingles gets his time in the quiet room after that one.